Moon Mondays, unleash your feminine power through astrology. I'm Sheridan, your go-to astrology life coach, sharing this week's woman-centered astrology, empowering you to use astrology to realize your potential. This week of October 21st, we begin with the moon in Gemini moving into Cancer today. Venus is newly into Sagittarius, and the sun is spending her last day in Libra as she enters Scorpio tomorrow, Tuesday. The moon is waning after the full moon last week. So she's losing light, heading back towards the sun and the next new moon. The moon met with Jupiter early this morning for me, where I am in Colorado. They're both in Gemini, right? So the sign that implores us to get out of our rigid boxes and play and just like have some fun and lighten up, right? So how does that energy feel to you today? You know, how are you experiencing the Jupiterian amplification of the Gemini moon or vice versa? Later today, the moon will enter Cancer, which traditionalists say the moon rules, right? So I always wonder about that. Planets ruling signs, or even said to be happy in certain signs and unhappy in other signs. Is the moon happier in Cancer than it is in Capricorn? I personally don't use detriments and falls in my astrology practice. I think each planet has a valuable place in every sign, which is only really meant to help us like grow and evolve. So I say, don't worry if you read that the moon is in fall in Scorpio, if you have a Scorpio moon, right? There's no good or bad or right or wrong in divine feminine astrology. You are here to walk your unique path and to grow and learn from it throughout your life, right? That's all good in my book. Even if sometimes you, me, us all go through challenging times, right? We all do. I'm not into traditional astrology that tells you having a planet in a certain sign means you're screwed, right? I don't see how that's helpful at all. You're here for a reason, and I know your soul's got you, right? So, how does the moon moving into Cancer feel for you? Nurturing and unconditional love are major themes of Cancer. So, how do you want to use that energy for you? Venus, our divine feminine planet, is still moving through Sagittarius, right? The fiery, individualist, philosopher, adventurer sign. So, how does that feel to you? What are you experiencing? Are you feeling a call to explore more of yourself, your purpose, your truth? Tomorrow, Tuesday, the sun enters Scorpio and we move towards Samhain, right? That Celtic celebration of Samhain and Halloween next week. They're coming together, right? So, first, I can't believe it's almost the end of October. Like, where's October gone? And then the fact that they're right together on Samhain, but we'll talk more about that next week. So the sun, our planet of light, is moving into deep feeling water sign Scorpio. Again, what will you notice? How will you feel with that change? Scorpio invites us inside ourselves. It brings an energy that likes to live in the extremes, right? Scorpio thrives on intensity. Intensity of feeling and emotions. Scorpio is always seeking the juice, right? The most energy out of life. Interestingly, the sun squares Pluto, the planet of uncovering our true selves through deep feeling, just before it enters Scorpio, as if it's enticing us to take a deep look at our Libra relationships, right? Libra comes before Scorpio, before we shine our sunlight into Scorpio, where we do the deepest feeling growth, right? Often exactly through the pain that our relationships can provide. So I think it's really interesting that we have this connection between the sun and Pluto. as the sun is leaving Libra and moving into Scorpio, right? So relationships, deep diving, where do we find that juice in our life, that healing that helps us uncover who we truly are, often through our relationships with family, friends, partners, etc. So on Wednesday, the moon meets with Mars from around midnight until the sun rises. So if you're out late, you can look to see where Mars is, or if you're up early. So this provides an activation of the divine masculine planet, Mars, right? Well, both are in Cancer. So Mars inspires action, movement. This alignment asks, how are you with taking care of yourself before others, is what I would say, right? Cancer is like the mom on the airplane. She has to put on her own oxygen mask first before assisting her kids, because if she goes down, everyone is going down, right? So Cancer often needs to learn that lesson, right? Needs to learn to nurture and take care of herself first. She must learn how to unconditionally love herself before she can bestow that gift on anyone else. The moon and Mars meeting provides a check-in point along these lines, right? How are you doing with putting yourself first out of love for you? Late Wednesday, early Thursday, the moon leaves Cancer and enters Leo, the lioness, who is all about modeling self-love for us, right? So keep leaning into that shared teaching of Cancer and Leo, of taking care of ourselves and loving ourselves first, right? Our cup needs filling before we can offer or share it with others. How does the moon in Leo affect you, right? How are you with self-care and self-love, right? Is that good for you? Is it something you're learning about and trying to get better at? Or is it something that just like triggers the crap out of you, right? All of that's valid. It's just all about our learning and the growth opportunity that all of the planets' movements and the signs provides for us. On Thursday, the Leo moon squares off with the Scorpio sun for the third quarter, or the last quarter moon, right? So look for this waning half moon in the sky at sunset. We are in the reflective half of the moon cycle. So evaluating the last few weeks, learning and growing into our next new moon intention for next week. So how has your previous intention gone for you during this moon cycle, right? Have you been able to accomplish it? If not, why? What didn't work for you about it? Is it too big, too ambitious, not actually aligned with what you want, right? It's not a time to like judge ourselves of what we've done or not done. It's just to take a look and reevaluate, right? So the third quarter moon is the time to take that internal look and begin revising what you want to set your intention for at the Scorpio new moon on Samhain next week, right? Gotta love that timing. Scorpio new moon, Samhain, Halloween, man, all of those energies are converging, which is really fun. We close out this week with the moon entering Virgo, where my personal moon sits. And I always think that's going to be great, right? The moon is returning to my moon sign. But I often find that while the moon is in Virgo, it brings out my shadow Virgo side of like anxiety and perfectionism. But maybe this go around will be different, right? I'm always trying to grow and evolve. And so I hold out the hope that this Virgo moon will be the one that I'm always looking for. So Virgo, the priestess sign who reminds us to connect with the earth spiritually and prepare for the Celtic holy day of Samhain next week, right? Where we honor the autumnal energies in the Northern Hemisphere where I live. Those of you in the South, you'll be preparing for Beltane and the awakening of spring, right? The energies, but still coming together. See you next Monday to discuss this and more, and look at setting our Scorpio Halloween, Samhain, new moon intentions. If you want to learn more about creating your ideal life with the moon, you can grab my free guide, 3 Steps to Changing Your Life with the New Moon, at my website, SheridanSemple.com, or click the link below. comment, ask me questions, and like below if you feel so inspired. Thanks for watching, and I wish you a feminine empowered week.